One aspect of stroke care at our center is the fact that the patient, rather than being offloaded to an emergency room gurney immediately, is kept on the EMS stretcher all the way through the initial assessment to the CT scan. We call this the race car pit stop model of stroke care. When a race car comes into the pits, it is descended upon by a pit crew, each doing a different job, but working together. In auto racing, the goal is to get the car back out on the track in the minimum amount of time, because each second in the pits can translate to over 250 feet on the track. The race car pit stop model of stroke care uses a similar idea. The patient is descended upon by a pit crew of nurses and a stroke physician, each doing different jobs, but working together. In this case, however, it's not distance on the track that is saved, but the amount of function regained following a stroke. So what can you tell me?
Yeah, so this is Brett. He's a 42-year-old male. At 12:15, he had a witness onset difficulty speaking, slurred speech, right-sided leg drift, right arm paresis.
When the patient arrives into the emergency department, it's a beehive of activity. While the physician is getting the patient history from EMS and patient's family member, a nursing staff converge on the patient. Saline locks are established, the patient is triaged into emerge, lab work is drawn, as well as a glucometer and a point of care INR.
So our time last seen well was 45 minutes ago?
Approximately, yeah.
Okay, good, so we're in good time.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Dr. Samus, you are?
Hi, I'm Brett's wife, Tracy.
Can you tell me what happened today?
We were at Applefest and we were walking after the parade with that out, and we were walking across the street and he had a bag of apples in his hand and he dropped them, and then he was unable to grasp them or pick them up, and the next thing I knew he was laying on the ground.
Okay. Was his speech any different?
Yes, it was slurred and not coherent.
And just before that he was fine?
He was fine.
And his arm didn't seem to be working when he was picking up the apples?
He couldn't seem to grasp them, no.
Okay, and that's different?
Yes.
Okay, and what time did this happen?
About 12:15.
Okay, so about 45 minutes.
Yes.
Okay. Hi there, I'm Dr. Samus. How are you?
I'm good.
Are you having any pain?
No.
Okay, I just have a few questions for you. How old are you?
42.
Is that right?
That's correct.
Okay. And what month is this?
July.
Okay, good. I want you to do a few things for me. The physician then carries out a stroke scale, which allows an assessment of how severe the stroke is. I want you to just look at this pen here and follow it with your eyes, okay? Follow it over to you. Proper training of the nursing staff and the stroke physician to work in concert is key. The use of concurrent activity, doing things in parallel, rather than series, allows for the quick accomplishment of tasks. Sometimes the stroke physician must be adaptive in the use of the stroke scale, often leaving the motor arm to the end to allow the nursing staff to establish their IVs and draw blood. I'm gonna do this with your arm now. You're gonna hold it up to the count of 10. I want your palms out like that and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's good. And on this side, okay. Can you tell me what you see in this picture?
Girl, dishes, boy, cookies.
Can you read those for me?
You know how down to earth.
Okay, we're ready to go to CT. One of the secondary effects of having the EMS crew present during the initial assessment, with everyone understanding how valuable their time is that it creates a social pressure to keep the enterprise moving forward, getting the patient to CT and that crew back on the road. The overhead page is an important notification for those people in CAT scan that a stroke is on the way. For any elective patients being scanned, they're removed from the scanner to make room for the priority scan for the stroke patient.
My name's Doug Socha, I'm Paramedic Chief for Hastings-Quinte Paramedic Services. When paramedics arrive at the emergency room, the patient that is on the paramedic stretcher will be transferred onto the hospital emergency room bed. There's a verbal report that's given to the emergency room team and a transfer of care occurs. Also, any equipment that's attached to the patient is removed as the patient is moved over onto the hospital bed. This is really important for us to get back into the community to respond to the next emergency call. In the race car pit stop model, the patient remains on the paramedic stretcher the entire time until they reach the CT scanner. There's no transfer of the patient into the emergency room, and that invests a little bit extra time for paramedics to be with that patient. We conducted a 2-year review of all stroke patients and found there was a 6-minute increase in time that paramedics were with those patients compared to those who had a heart attack with the same level of acuity. As the chief of the paramedic services, the working relationship that we have with Quinte Healthcare Corporation has allowed this race car pit stop model to be a valuable investment. I personally feel that the amount of time that paramedics can spend with the patient that we have in order to get them to the CT scanner in the shortest amount of time, when they're losing 1.9 million brain cells per minute, it's important that we want to decrease that time. Paramedics are not spending a great amount of time in the hospital. The working relationship we have with the organization and the entire stroke team is fantastic, and they've done everything to make sure that we get back on the road as quickly as possible. In reviewing the data, we've noticed that most of these code strokes are occurring during the day when we have additional resources on the road. This has not resulted in any significant increase in response time in the community by investing the additional 6 minutes to transfer the patient directly to the CT scanner.